Stand back, friend. You don't want to get this stuff on you, believe me.
I feel like I've fleshed 100 skins today.
Stay focused, will you?
Careful how you pack that leather. Any creases or
scratches? You! Finally! No one was paying me the slightest heed.
Is something wrong?
At the university, the students would hang on my every word. Sadly, this far from home, I'm just a vagrant greybeard.
The university? You're a scholar.
A specialist in ancient cultures, the most accomplished in all Valisthea, some have said. Not that I look the part in these tattered rags. In my heyday, no obstacle could have kept me from my studies. Yet here I am, a wizened windbag, bested by the many steps of Tabor. The answers I seek lying just beyond my enfeebled reach. Would you do an old man a kindness and brave the stairs in my stead? You'll be amply rewarded, of course.
Climb the stairs and...
And memorize a few inscriptions for me. Assuming you know your letters, that is. Some courteous soul is rumored to have carved clues to Tabor's rich history into stones dotted about the village. Three of them, to be precise. One each to the north, south, and east. I'm here in the hope that those carvings might shed light on a riddle I've been pondering for some time. Namely, the otherwise undocumented origins of Tabor's unique people. A people quite unlike those of neighboring lands.
I can't promise I'll remember everything perfectly.
Remember what you can. I'll piece together the rest. Make for the domed pavilions, and you'll have no trouble finding the stones.
Careful how you pack that leather. Any creases or scratches?
Beneath the flood, yes.
How are those new boots treating you?
Why won't the sky go back to how it was?
So it's these stones to Canva, and the rest of the boxes to...
nothing like a dish of cold vengeance to foul the gut.
I'm sorry, Nan. I didn't mean to make things worse. I just thought I had to protect you. Like you've protected me.
Aye. Well, someone had to. Your parents certainly didn't give a whit for your well-being. Reckon the both of us would be worse off if I'd not taken you on. You've always been me right eye, Goots. And I'd have you stay that way. So don't you dare go looking for trouble again.
Well, I will. If you ever need help, I'll do it again and again. And you can't stop me.
Why, you big lump. Fine. Play the hero if it makes you happy.
Thanks, Nan. I won't let you down.
There's nothing he wouldn't do for you.
That's as maybe. But if he's ever to make his own way in life, he'll need to start looking out for himself as well. Till then, he'll need people to watch his back, just like you did in Dalamil. Don't think I didn't appreciate that.
Of course. His family.
Stop it. You made me one good eye, mister. I don't go thinking that'll do you any favours. A potion today will cost you the same as it did yesterday.
Sorry for the wait, but hopefully you'll agree it was worth it.
You learned something about our sword, then?
I did better than that. A whetstone? Yes. But not one you'll find anywhere in Valisthea.
Finish on the grinding wheel. One hit and all done, eh? Might not be so bad if all you ever fought were duels. Good luck on the battlefield. Your second opponent would be your last, no matter how good you were.
Even so, is there some way it could be used to give the curse breakers an edge?
I think so, yeah. With this whetstone and the right kind of steel, I could probably even make a twin of the blade to rattle me. But there'd be no replacing this little rock once I worn it down to a sliver. I reckon we get a dozen swords from it, if that. Swords that the curse breakers wouldn't know how to wield properly, and that would see them through a single fire piece. Nah, no point trying to copy that thing. Be about as much use as a wax anvil. But finishing our blades with a whetstone is fine. Now that's something to consider. And what's finer than fallen masonry, eh? Or more hard-wearing, for that matter. Just imagine it. Good Valisthean steel with an edge as sharp as any found in the Outer Isles. I won't make a copy, nah. I'll make something much better.
I'm sure the Curse Breakers will be delighted. Just don't push yourself too hard.
Now you worry about me, Sunshine. I'll be working day and night since I was half your age, and I'll still be here when you're long gone. Hey, thanks, Clive. I mean it. I owe you one, August 2. It's good to know someone's looking out for me.
You'll be happy to hear you said that.
And I'll see that my debt to you's paid. First new blade I make's got your name on it. You come and find me when you've got the materials.
All right. I will.
Sangfornian, dear. That it? Fine.
see the pair that got hauled into tires? The free cities. See?
Ah!
mess with the leader of the pack, eh, boy?
We sent curse breakers to Martha's Rest, Dalamil, and Northridge. Hopefully they can.
Is done.
Let me tell you a story, Clive.
All right.
Them rumours Wetlegs were spreading. Might be they weren't just tales plucked out of thin air. You see, there were a time when I weren't too particular about who I sold steel to, so long as they paid me the right price. Some women lust after blood, others after flesh, but me, I were always one for gold. To satisfy that lust, I sold to opposing armies, stabbed my every client in the back, made myself the most hated woman in the Twins. But then one day I met a man who made me a different kind of offer. Said he'd give me access to a realm-wide community of like-minded individuals in constant need of steel and sundries. On the condition I sold to him and his alone.
Was that the first time you met Sid?
Aye. And I fell right into his damn trap. He was true to his word, so I ended up being true to mine. And I soon started making the best profits I'd seen since taking up the trade. And all without aiding or abetting any outlaws. Except Sid himself, that is. Told me about his plan to topple the Mother Crystals, you know. Said that with them gone, the realm would want for all manner of things. An opportunity for the likes of me to mint guild.
Why, I reckon an enterprising individual could find herself the richest damn in the Twins.
And that's when he had me. I emptied my stores that day and moved into the Hideaway proper. And the rest, as they say, is ancient bloody history. A dozen years on, and I'm still not the richest damn. Not for lack of trying, mind. But I can say that I have never been happier. You've all shown me there are some things more precious than Gil.
That there are.
So don't you go messing it all up, or you'll have me to answer to. Still alive, are you? Coin purse weighing you down. You'll not find a better price than that. Finished, are you?
Ah!
No more vengeance. No more war.
We sent Cursebreakers to Martha's Rest, Dalamil, and Northridge.
Build a barricade so sturdy, even abandoned.
Let's go. Run like the wind.
Certainly call it. If I were a giant antelope, it would seem like just the place.
I doubt we'll find one bigger than that. You hungry, Torgal? Stay down!
Now,
be enough, I wonder. I say that answers my question, which means we owe the Lawsmen our thanks. You're just a big puppy, aren't you? A very big puppy. You do know you can take that with you, Togo. Lady Karen will be relieved to hear you've got your appetite back. Come on, boy. Seems this one has a little more life left in it. All right then.
Yeah.
back to sleep, Theo.
Noticed you and Torgal had gone off somewhere. Took him for a walk, did you?
You could say that.
So, Molly's leftovers weren't good enough, eh? That'll teach me for treating you like you're still a pup. All right, no need to shout. Now we know what you're after, I can see about getting some in.
Speaking of which, I brought one for later. Can I leave it with you?
You can, aye. I'm nice like that. In return, you can thank Tomes for me. The bloody know-it-all.
I was just on my way to see him.
It's a dangerous world out there. I don't know many fleshers are dealing cuts that size. Well, that doesn't mean I don't know some. Go on, then. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. Come again. Oh, don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
There's a storm coming, Sid.
Ah, Clive. Were you able to locate your quarry?
We were indeed, Lawsman. You pointed us in exactly the right direction. And Torgal's been a very happy hound ever since.
Very good, very good.
Lady Karen sends her thanks, by the way, for your part in solving the mystery.
Ah. But that reminds me. After your last visit, I found myself pondering Torgal's talents. Do you recall our conversation concerning Lady Jill's role in Torgal's transformation?
About how she somehow woke the power within him.
Precisely that. A reasonable conclusion, I thought. But one which raised certain questions in my mind. You see, the Fenrir of legend served Shiva and Shiva alone. And while the powers attributed to him are certainly impressive, the records imply they are somewhat different in nature to those you described Torgal as having used.
What are you suggesting?
That Torgal may be the beneficiary of more than one icon's power. Consider that in addition to Lady Jill, he has served as a loyal companion to you, your brother, and even the late Cid. In short, the icons hitherto near at hand, or should I say at paw, have been diverse and plenty, and that number has only grown as the realm's dominance have fallen to your sword. One can but speculate as to how all of this has affected Torgal.
He has seemed more fierce of late.
And if I'm not mistaken, he will grow fiercer still. We are fortunate indeed to be able to count him amongst our allies and not our adversaries.
Oh, he's more than an ally. He's a friend.
Seems the hideaway is lost.
Sounds like thunder.
You're late. We're starting to think you'd stumbled off a cliff.
I seem to recall that was you, Gav.
Good to see you. Any trouble on the road?
Nothing we couldn't handle.
I knew you'd come. Is that who I think it is? Yes.
Allow me to introduce my brother, Joshua.
Clive's told me all about you. Or even listening most of the time. Name's Midadol, but everyone calls me Mid.
My lady.
Hey.
My boy. Uncle Byron.
It's really you. I never thought I'd see the day.
So these Akashic are being controlled.
That's what it looked like. Empty eyes, eerie blue glow. No doubt they were turned, but silent as monks, every last one of them.
Your man here speaks true, Clive. We saw more than a few in the city. They moved in ranks with a purpose, and not of their own.
Ultima's doing.
Perhaps.
What of the city? The people?
Dead, mostly.
Mostly, but not all. A handful managed to lock themselves in their villas before the Horde arrived. Some in the merchant's district to the west, and a few others on the far bank.
If the Akashic stumble across either hiding place, a few bolted doors won't hold them for long. We need to find them. And quickly.
What do you propose?
We split into two parties. I will make for the merchant's district, while you look to those across the river. Mind keeping an eye on my brother?
Not at all. We find the villa and try the servants' entrance.
Understood.
And what of us?
Mid, is she fit to sail?
The ship? The Mithril engine could probably do with a few more tweaks.
Then you better work fast. Even if we do reach the survivors in time, they'll never make it to the hideaway on foot.
You leave that to me.
See that Mid doesn't get herself into trouble, would you?
Think I can manage that.
I'll keep him safe.
Looks like you're stuck with me, Byron.
That's Lord Rossfield, you little guttersnipe.
Shall we then?
And you keep Clive safe.
Be careful. Both of you.
You too.
Torgul, let's find those survivors. They don't stand a chance against those things. Fuck. They're wearing Waluda armor.
There's nothing but monsters here. Sounded big. Joshua and Jill must be busy.
Thank you.
This is the Agora, where the city's leaders gather. There may still be survivors inside.
You've caused quite the commotion. But then I would expect no less from you, Muthos.
You again. I don't believe we've been introduced. You were in my family's crypt, and now you're here, with an army of Akashic thralls.
Manners, Lord Rosfield? They are men, like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
What?
And they are all that remains in this once raucous city.
You'll pay for what you've done.
As you wish. I confess, I have been very much looking forward to this. Pardon me, this indulgence, Your Majesty. The vessel shall not be spoiled. I am safely out of House Harvard, and you will yield. Or not. As long as you don't hold back. Nice try. Forgive me if my performance seems uninspired. It is just that I expected so much more from our chosen one. Perhaps this will kindle your flame.
What now?
A gift from my liege lord's armory. Gungnir. Watch closely, Mythos. The vessel is strong. My liege.
Clive!
You're all right.
As are you, I see.
We are, yes.
I'm sorry, but we couldn't save them.
It was over before we arrived.
Well, you did what you could. I fear we were all too late. What's wrong?
Nothing. I hope.
Found her.
Leaving so soon, Muthos?
It's the king.
Indeed. You may kneel before Barnabas Tharm, Warden of Ash and King of Walud. Get back. Bested my lord commander. Yet I see why my master covets you so. The power within you, Muthos. The potential.
Stop calling me Muthos.
But Muthos is everything. The cornerstone of all creation. The lord's vessel. Your purpose.
Purpose? To surrender my mind and body to that thing. No, Your Majesty. My purpose is my own. I made a promise to my friends, to my people. And nothing is going to stand in my way.
You would allow this delusion of free will to bar your path to greatness? Truly, your volition is a cancer, one that must be excised. Reckoning, and they use it as a crutch. Such a waste.
Will you be all right?
The phoenix can mend flesh, but the spirit must recover on its own. I'm afraid the rest is up to him. He This place is remarkable. Outfitting it must have been no small feat. But why go to such trouble?
That beauty's belly is filled with wonders the world ain't ready for. If the guilds caught wind of what we're up to, they'd all want a piece. All right.
And how is he? Do not blame yourself. He was barely breathing when you brought him here. We would have lost him if it were not for you.
No. Barnabas may have severed nigh every sinew in my brother's body. But he made certain the wounds were not fatal.
Nigh every sinew?
Allow me, your lordship. Don't know what I was thinking, putting you to the trouble like that.
Tis no trouble carrying comestibles to my ailing nephew.
I know, but you've already done so much for us. Pouring your gill into the hideway and now the ship. I don't want to take the piss.
You risked your life. And for what? Some gill you hardly know. Why'd you do it? You got mad or something?
I wouldn't go that far.
Clive!
You're awake.
My boy.
What I want to do is help. And the world won't save itself. It was Sid. Your father, who taught me that.
Sounds like him.
Don't you dare do that again.
What of the Royalists?
Fucked off, a lot of them. Along with the galleon. With the king on board, no doubt. Behind here, I wouldn't sail without him. Clive. Jill didn't come back.
What do you mean?
She kept the king busy while the others stretched you out.
It's all right, mate. Jill is fine.
The ether of her icon endures. And as long as it does, we can be certain she is alive.
We must pursue the Black Galleon. Jill will be with the king, I'm sure of it.
Well, good luck catching him, because my ship's going nowhere. It's the Mithril engine. She's got a kick like a wild chocobo and a mind to tear the hull in half.
But do you have an idea?
Well, of course I do. My dad has seen this coming a league off. If I had his old writings...
If you had his old writings, you'd be sitting under a fuckload of rubble. The ones Otto didn't save anyway. I suppose you might still have a few pages in his stores.
We'll have to hope that's enough. Do what you can to ready the ship. I'll speak with Otto.
In your condition, you really are mad.
Perhaps. But the world really won't save itself.
Gav said that Otto might know something.